If you've been following my newsletter, blog, YouTube channel, or if you've read my new book, The Plant Paradox, you know beans and nightshades are two of the worst things that you can eat. They're packed with tiny proteins called lectins. And lectins trigger low-level inflammation in your body. This inflammation ultimately leads to chronic disease and age-related health problems. Now, many people who follow my plan just give up beans and nightshades entirely. And if that works for you, great. But let's be honest. Sometimes it's hard to give up that caprese salad or that big bowl of chili. Well, fortunately, there is a way around all of those lectins, and it involves the humble pressure cooker. Now, chances are you grew up with one of these in the house. Now, don't worry, though. Today's pressure cookers aren't the scary ones your grandmother had in the house that blew up across the ceiling. The new ones aren't prone to explosions, and the digital ones are especially easy to use. So how do you prepare these lectin-rich foods so that they're safe to eat? Well, today I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough. It'll be enough to get you started. For a more in-depth look at how to prepare Gundry-compliant beans and nightshade recipes, keep an eye on the YouTube channel. We'll post some very detailed recipe videos shortly. And remember, even when prepared correctly, beans and nightshades shouldn't be a huge part of your everyday diet. So first, let's talk about how to prepare beans. So step one, soak the beans in 2 changes of water, 3 to be safe. Change it out every couple hours, or better yet, do it overnight or even 24 hours. The water starts removing the lectins, because some of them leach out into the water. So next, you put the beans in the pressure cooker, along with salt, pepper, and oil. Consider adding an onion or a bay leaf too. It gives great added flavor. Then add the appropriate amount of water on the recipe. If you're cooking, say, 1 pound of beans, and this is about 1 pound, just add 6 cups of water. Remember, your pressure cooker should never be more than half full. Now, you pressure cook for about 20 minutes once the pot reaches pressure. As few as 10 minutes for smaller beans like lentils, or up to 30 minutes for larger beans like kidney beans. So you release the pressure according to the instructions that came with your pressure cooker, and then you're ready. All right, let's move on to the nightshades. For nightshades, step one is peeling and de-seeding them. Now, I'm not going to get into the how-to for every single nightshade, but let's talk about the 3 most common. For eggplant, peel the eggplant with a vegetable peeler. And there's serrated vegetable peelers now that are just fantastic. And then you cut it in half and you scoop out the seeds with a spoon. So for peppers, first cut the peppers in half, scoop out the seeds and the white membrane and throw them away. Roast the peppers in a very hot skillet or over an open flame until the skin is charred. So then you place the now roasted peppers in a paper bag and let them sit for about 5 minutes. And then you can just remove the skin by rubbing it with a paper towel. You can also try peeling the skin with a very sharp knife or with that vegetable peeler, but it's a lot more difficult. So for tomatoes, you want to peel the tomato with a serrated vegetable peeler, and they're really better on soft fruits than the straight blades. Or what you do is you actually score an X onto the bottom of the whole tomato, then drop it in a pot of boiling water for about 30 seconds. Then take the tomato out of the water, please use a spoon, and peel where it's beginning to peel away naturally, where you made the X. Then you cut the tomato in half and scoop out the seeds with a spoon. So to pressure cook your nightshades, just put them in the pressure cooker. You actually don't have to peel and de-seed them, but that'd be nice. And put in some salt, pepper, minced garlic, and onions. Throw in a couple cups of water. Pressure cook for about 3 minutes once the pot reaches pressure. Then you release the pressure according to the instructions that came with your pressure cooker, and you're all set. Now just remember, this is not an everyday thing, but a special occasion treat for when you need that bowl of chili or tomato sauce. After all, I want you to feel healthy and not deprived. Because I'm Dr. Stephen Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you. Thanks for watching. Click the circular channel icon to subscribe and make sure you don't miss a single video. Click on the left to watch another great video, and don't forget to visit my website for more of my best tips, because I'm Dr. Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you.